Now children, in this video we are revising just the structures of methane, ammonia and water. Why? Because these are often asked, especially these two. So when you will calculate with the formula which I have given you for the calculation of hybridization, you will find that they all get sp3. The shape is tetrahedral in this case, but in case of ammonia, instead of tetrahedral, because of the presence of one lone pair, it gets distorted tetrahedral, which is precisely called as pyramidal shape. So you have to remember both the terms. And then in case of water, we have got two lone pairs, hence the shape is bent or angular or V-shape. When we have particular proper tetrahedral, when there's no lone pair with sp3, the angle is 109 degrees 28 minutes. But when we have one lone pair, due to a bit more repulsion, the angle goes down 107 degrees. And when there are two lone pairs, in case of water, the angle value further goes down to 104.5 degrees. This short video I prepared so that you remember very well that all these sp3, but different angles and different shapes, different geometries, which is often asked. I repeat, these two are often asked. So this is how. It's not that once it is sp3, it will all be all the time tetrahedral. It is not so, children. It depends upon bond pair and lone pair. So with lone pair, I would say you have mainly these two cases. Otherwise, mainly remaining what all are there in your sp or sp2 or any other type of hybridization, you'll find that they ask you mainly with bond pairs only. So this is all for your VSEPR theory and hybridization. I've taken all important points, right? Again, I would say keeping in mind the time limit, but that's also very essential, right? So otherwise one can go much deeper and can do a lot in hybridization. What all was important was required, we have done. So for this video, I stop here.